Saturday morning, last full training day of the week, and then we have a deload week starting on Monday. Yesterday didn't record too much training, I just got it done out of the way. I was kind of feeling tired, so I wanted to just get it out of the way. Did a wee bit of accessory stuff there yesterday evening. Accessory pieces done for the night. So all we had to do was 4 rounds, 10 strict pull-ups, 10 reverse grip lat pull-downs, 12 ring dips, and then 10 of those tricep extensions on each side. French press or something they're called. I don't know what they're called. 10 of them on each side now. But now we're back up and at it, and ready to go now for the last day. Grab a coffee, grab one of them wee multivitamin things, and then we'll start training now. Right, just landed here, we get started. What we're gonna do first is just a kind of a warm-up, just 10 minutes of handstand walk practice. Use that as a warm-up, then we're gonna get into some strict deficit handstand push-ups, some back squats with a pause, we'll hit a 40-minute EMOM, and then we'll do the class workout. So that's the plan, let's get started. Handstand walking just as a wee warm up, 10 minutes of practice on that, and now I'm going to do some strict deficit handstand push-ups. Right, back squats next, 3x3 at 120 with a 5-second eccentric on the way down. I have no power in the legs at all. Never did. Probably never will, but enjoy the process and losing train. So, right, back squat's done. 40-minute EMOM now next. Spicy EMOM. That's us ready. I'm going to jump in with the 10 o'clock class on Saturday. I'm going to hit that workout then when they arrive. Oh, that's tough. Workout for Saturday is 4 rounds for time, 25 toes to bar, 500 meter row, 4 lengths of a double dumbbell front rack, walk and lunge. We're going to rest 2 minutes between each round. Training all done, just finish this protein shake and then I'll hit the bricks. I was planning to go to the Carndale this morning at about 8 o'clock beforehand, but I had that much stuff to do training wise, I wanted to get it done before the class start. So fingers crossed now, like, when there's scones left. So just as I expected, Carndale sold out of scones. So I ended up getting just a loaf, or a scone loaf, or a scone bread, or whatever you call this. Wheaton bread, that's the name, that's it. So we got that, a wee bit of strawberry jam for two. We got some other stuff then too, a couple of bagels, a bit of lettuce, brioche bun, chicken fillets, a couple of tomatoes. Might have like chicken burgers for lunch. Pat, will you stop, sir? Sick, gone and stop. Ready? This is what happens when you rush. Your bagel and your red sauce ends up falling off the plate and slap bang on the floor. Why is it too that it always falls like sauce end down? Like if you had toast or if you had anything with butter or just whatever you have on, always ends up face down the floor. Aye, and for anybody thinking, is he actually going to eat that? Yes, of course. That's going to be scraped up, cleaned off and yet. Waste not, want not, folks. So I might just do like a bit of a full day of eating kind of a thing today of what I eat on an average day. First thing I eat every day when I get finished training is the exact same as 3 egg omelette with a bit of hot sauce on the top, a bagel with 2 turkey puddings and 2 turkey sausages in it. And that's meal number one every day, along with a cup of tea. So that's breakfast, lunch should be next.
Self a merry little Christmas, million dreams.
I don't know why that Christmas song is stuck in my head, but it is. Right, it's Saturday and there's football on. I don't really follow football that much, but I do like to put an old accumulator on the weekend. So there's a couple of games on. Maybe if there's any luck, I might win thousands of pounds. Right, lunchtime and I've made 2 chicken fillet burgers and they do look delicious. Chicken fillets, tomatoes, lettuce, a brioche bun. We got that Southwest sauce in it as well and it is tasty. The 2 of these now and then I get a cup of tea and a bit of scone after. I hope you weren't eating them. I left the scone down the table, they come up to get the tea and I just hope he didn't eat it. Oh no, right. Good man. Right. Dessert after the chicken fillet burgers. Went for 2 slices of the corner delis.
I'll tell you that much for free. That snow, freezing.
Was the best boy, wouldn't even take it off the plate. The best boy.
I'm fed there now for lunch. I'm gonna go back down and do accessories at 4:15 now. I'll probably head down about 5 o'clock to gym now and do a bit of accessory work. And then we'll get the dinner in after that. That wraps up Saturday night's accessories. Just nice and steady. Wee bit of a pump. That's it now, dinner time. Not sure what to eat. I'm not feeling that wild hungry. That scone bread kind of stuffed me, so I might get like, I don't know, fish maybe or something. I gotta see. Right. We'll go to the shop now and see what the store is. We were late in the bathroom getting home now, 8:40. Ended up going for cod fillet.
2 in a pack, so I'll throw on the 2 packs there. We'll have 4 of them fillets. Bag of spuds and then these wee pepper sauces here, wine handy. Maybe 2 of them. Whenever I was in there, I got a box of rices as well because I am a sore man on rice during the week, so top up.
four fine cod fillets here in a bag of spuds, peppered salt, lovely. Last meal or snack, I suppose you'd nearly call it, of the day then is just a protein bar. One of the full chocolate and peanut butter and a cup of tea. So that's a full day of eating. Boring enough stuff, I suppose, really, just normal food like, but maybe we'll do more exciting one whenever we finish up the competition as a wee bit of a celebration. I do track the food I eat as well during the day, and the goal was 3,450 calories. I end up going over that, usually do. 3,878 total calories for the day. So that's the vlog for today. See you tomorrow. Good night.